deep for the Broncos. And to handle the kickoff duties, Pat McAfee, and we are just about set to go. Actually ran into the referee prior to the football game, walking over here. And his Tom Tomczyk is the referee. We'll be hearing from him during the course of the afternoon. That's Brandon West, the deep man for the Broncos, the team that won 8 games a year ago and put up a stiff battle in the International Bowl in Toronto against Cincinnati. And they're very familiar with the Big East. Bill Miller and, of course, Bill Cubitt were also assistants in the Big East earlier in their career. This one will start inside and will not come out. So McAfee kicks it into the end zone. West takes a knee, and we're about set to see this offense come out. Tim Hiller will be the quarterback, replacing the coach's son, Ryan Cubitt, who he coached for a couple of years. He'll be the starting quarterback for Western Michigan, a guy that played 2 years ago and then suffered a knee injury and had to rehab all of last year. But he did start 7 games, or played in 7 games 2 years ago as a true freshman, and now as a redshirt sophomore after the injury rehab, he gets the call. It'll be interesting to see, because they had the experience of Ryan Cubitt. Now they turn it over to Tim Hiller. And 4 wide receivers to the right, no backs, the quick toss, and the Mountaineers are all over it. The pass was to Julian, and let's take a look at the rest of this lineup for Western Michigan offensively. The one guy you might want to keep an eye on is Snyder Julian. He's a junior, and his coach sometimes inverts his name backwards and forwards, so they just call him Spider. But he's got plenty of speed, and he's a guy that can go deep. A loss of 3 on the first play. There is the offensive line. Crutella certainly a veteran in the middle, but they did lose a outstanding guard in Dominic Moran, and we'll see if Philip Swanson can fill that slot. This time they go with the 1 setback. And time. 2nd down and 13. On the option, the toss comes to West, and he'll get back to the 15, and that's it. Ryan Mundy, the young man we just talked about, led the charge defensively for West Virginia. They'll lose 2 more, and it goes back to the 15. It'll be 3rd down and 15. And the coach, Bill Cubitt, in his 3rd year.
I think you remember that.
Absolutely. You would, wouldn't you? Just about 2.5 minutes gone out of the shotgun. Hiller rolling right, looking, still looking, throws, and he's going to overthrow everybody. Nobody open. It was intended for Julian, but good coverage downfield, so it's 3 and out for the visitors, the Broncos. And this, I think, is one of the things they feared coming in, Renee, is that they would get in trouble early and the Mountaineers might strike quickly. That's one thing they're going to try to avoid under Bill Miller.
I think West Virginia won the first battle on defense. They confused, they loaded the box, and Hiller, who was the MAC freshman of the year, pretty cerebral guy, a 4.0 GPA, really didn't see what he liked there, and West Virginia wins the first battle. Now we're getting pretty good field position.
Vaughn Rivers will be back to receive the punt of Jim Laney, and it gets it away from about the 5-yard line. Vaughn Rivers backpedals inside the 30, cuts to his left at the 40, and he's nailed as he gets to about the 40-yard line, and that's where the Mountaineers will have it. Pretty good field position. 56-yard punt, a good punt, an 11-yard return, and there is Pat White. What a great job he has done in his time here in Morgantown. He is a redshirt junior, and he is Mr. Do Everything. The numbers are just incredible. As you mentioned, some of the great running quarterbacks have been in this league, and he has surpassed all of them.
And, you know, they have the regular tempo, the Indy tempo, and the jet tempo as far as no huddle offense. This must be the jet tempo right here.
Well, they'll play as fast as the officials will let them play, starting at the 41-yard line, their own 41. Pretty good field position going out of the shotgun. And there's the quick pass outside to Devine. And Love picks it up inside the 50 to the 45. Darius Raynaud, a 12-yard pickup for a first down. Check the other backs and receivers for this offense of West Virginia, but you have to keep your eye on one guy by the name of Owen Schmidt. That's the offensive line. They're doing a great job. There is one change along there from what we had thought earlier in the year. They made a change in the guard position, moving Hayes into the start. First and 10. Ball is at the 46-yard line of the Broncos. Inside handoff. Slayton squeezes at the 40, and he's dragged down from behind by Dustin Duclos. 8-yard pickup. The rest of the defense for the Broncos. You see this group, and they have been terrific. And even though as good as they were, they have made some changes. They'll play a lot of five defensive back coverage, and they'll probably also play a lot of man coverage. Pretty good speed by Biggers. We've talked about Delmas. It is second down and a couple. Ball at the 38-yard line. Working strictly out of the shotgun. White with his first run, and he's dragged down short of the
so well. It's a triple option, basically. He can run, hand it to Slayton or another back, or he can pass it. And you may see a little bit of his arm strength today.
And you'll also see a lot of Jock Sanders and Noel Devine. Boy, what great numbers he had coming out of Florida. Inside handoff, Schmidt, I don't know that he's going to make it. Schmidt will line up at tight end. He'll line up at fullback. We saw him line up at tailback. They'll split him out at times. But that time, Corey Flom was there defensively, and it's fourth and short.
Inside handoff to Schmidt, just running behind the inside zone play, and good fill by the inside guy. And you know, it's short, but he's going to go for it. Rich Rodriguez is very confident this will make a statement right here.
Well, the no backfield offense, four wideouts, two left, two right, and that usually means this guy's going to carry, and he does. He's dragged down as he gets inside the 30. And they are wearing Lewis Delmas out already in that defensive secondary. First down, Mountaineers 10-yard pickup.
Good blocking up front. And you know, the West Virginia offense is probably one of the best zone blocking offenses in the nation. Good blocking there, a gaping hole. They subscribe to the Denver Bronco way of blocking up front. And you don't need to be real big, just real smart, real quick. And there's a lot of running as far as offensive line play is concerned.
It's another first and 10. The ball is just inside the 28-yard line. The fake of the handoff, and White, showing his speed, somehow gets away and gets inside the 20 before he's dropped by Fryer and Delmas. So those guys in the secondary are going to make a lot of tackles this afternoon.
And the bad thing, you know, you don't want your safety being a leading tackler. Delmas has 53 stops last year, but he's getting a lot of work as Delmas comes up, and that's bringing him close, sucking him close to the line of scrimmage. You see him, good play there, but again, you don't want your safety playing that close, making tackles. It opens up to all the middle for slants and patterns such as that.
7-yard pickup, second down, 3. All the offense has been on the ground so far, and the motion man that time is Raynaud. And tumbling down just at the line of scrimmage. Again, it's Corey Flom inside defensively for the Broncos, and also some good play stuffing the middle from Nick the Catapane, doing a good job.
You know, Pat White is only 6'2", 185, but he's a lot stronger than he appears. Quick, a 4'4", 140. No quarterback is that quick in the country.
It is still third down and 3. Maybe changing the play. They go on the fly a lot, working strictly out of the shotgun so far. This is going to be the first pass, and it's a dandy. Touchdown, West Virginia. Making the catch is Dorrell Jala. Great slant route, and he was wide open over the middle.
And we talked about that. When you get your safeties up close to the line, they've been sucking them up. Delmas has been playing close to the line. They open up the middle. The corner cannot cover that slant pattern, and that was really set up well.
20-yard touchdown play.
Patrick White, good pass protection, just throws it right where it needs. Great separation from the cornerback. Steven did the best he could, but Jala with the touchdown catch. Early score here, 9:35 in the first quarter.
McAfee for the extra point out of the hold of Jeremy Cash. Long snapper is Adam Hughes. He puts it up and he puts it through. So West Virginia scores quickly on their first possession. And that's another thing that the Western Michigan coaches were worried about. Would they score quickly? They certainly did. 59 yards, 8 plays, 3:41 on the clock. And West Virginia, on the touchdown pass, takes the lead over Western Michigan.
And welcome back. West Virginia with an opening drive. 8 plays, 59 yards. And you can see Patrick White has set this up with the running play and sucking up the free safety. And now it opens up the slant pattern wide open to Jala for the score. At the 9:35 mark, West Virginia on the scoreboard leading 7-0 over Western Michigan.
And officially a 19-yard touchdown pass. So once again, it'll be Pat McAfee to kick off. And Brandon West is the deep man. West handled the opening kickoff but did not bring it out because McAfee put it about 3 yards deep in the end zone. So the kind of start these 60,000 dressed in old gold and blue wanted to see. This one is going to be out of bounds. So better.
I think the quarterback, whoever it is, 65%, 25 touchdowns should be the norm.
West is the lone setback. He's got the football. And he's got about 2 or 3 yards. Maybe falling forward for a gain of about 5. Williams, who's been bothered by some elbow problems, he was kind of questionable at that middle linebacker spot. Bobby Hathaway plays behind him. He had a hand injury, so they're a little banged up. He will pick up 5 on the play, make it 2nd down and 5.
And that West Virginia defense runs pretty well. The thing is, Western Michigan, their offense is a strength. They block very, very well. One of the best offensive lines in the country.
Hiller is the lone man in the backfield, out of the shotgun, looking right, throwing right, completes it. And it's going to be a 1st down.
Blitz and that coverage.
Well, you know, the defense of West Virginia, much maligned, almost getting to the quarterback.
I think they have the people to do that.
And that's the inside handoff to Glenn Thomas, and Thomas will get to about the 50. Changing the count at the line of scrimmage. Mountaineer fans trying to make some noise. Gets the pass away. It's almost intercepted. Almost intercepted that time by Wicks. Eric Wicks, number 41. Almost picked that one off, and he would have been gone.
Hiller throwing into zone coverage, and Wicks steps right in front. I think Hiller just forced this ball a little low trajectory. He's lucky they went kicking the extra point, but Wicks, I don't think he saw Wicks. He saw the receiver open for a second, waited a little too long, and just tried to hurry the throw.
Jim Laney will punt. Vaughn Rivers is back again for the Mountaineers, this time back near his 10-yard line. So 1 1st down on that possession. Very nice kick. They run away from it, and this is going to be a good spot for the defense of the Broncos as they let it trickle down to about the 2-yard line. 48-yard kick, no return, obviously. The Mountaineers have the lead. White and company set to come back on. They scored on their first possession. They've got 97 yards to go. When all smiles so far on a sunny Saturday in Morgantown. Mountaineers lead it 7-0. Midway point of the first half. They are starting deep in their own hole. And Schmidt is at the fullback spot right now. And we'll keep an eye on number 35 because Schmidt moves all over the place. Right now lined up as a true fullback in the I formation. And this is the first time, I think, that we've seen Patrick White under center. Slayton. Knife down as he gets to about the 4-yard line. He'll pick up a yard, maybe 2. Not much there at all. We talked about that defensive play. Pritchard made the tackle, but this is a pretty good defense for the Broncos with Davidson, the Catapane, Cialinski or Flom in the front, along with Marshall.
They're the best in the MAC. Best defense in the MAC.
2nd down play. They're going to throw deep down the middle. Raynaud makes the catch. He's at the 50, the 40. He loses the football. 8-yard pass play that would have put the Mountaineers in good field position. A little flea flicker action here, wide open to making the catch down the middle. The 34, a 31-yard gain, and this time it's West on the sweep trying to get outside. Knife down as he gets to the 27. William.
Offense because the play to Simmons and now this running play. And we talked about the offensive line blocked so well, kind of screened off and allowed the running back to get to the outside for a nice game.
Just over 6 minutes to play. Hiller is under center. And the quick out pass once again to DeMarco Simmons. He is ridden out of bounds along that near sideline. Ivy did the job defensively, but it's an 8-yard pickup. And they continue to march deep into West Virginia territory. And you know, you look back, Renee, at all the points the Mountaineers gave up the last 6 games of the season. That is certainly a concern for this coaching staff.
Yeah, and it didn't end on a good note, although the bowl game was successful. But the last part of the season, the defense gave up a ton of points. And right now, Western Michigan is moving down with a lot of confidence. And they got a nice drive going here following that turnover.
Just outside the 20, 1st and 10. West tries to go inside, and there's not much there. 0 on the play, and it's Mark Magro from Morgantown, West Virginia. You know, you touched a little bit earlier on the walk-on situation here. And of course, Rich Rodriguez himself was a walk-on. Owen Schmidt was a walk-on after he played at a very small college for a year and then came here and earned his way. And it's amazing what they've been able to do with that program here.
26 walk-ons have been awarded scholarships in the last 5 years. And that rewards a guy for hard work. You got some superstars blended in with some blue-collar guys. It's a nice blend here for the Mountaineers.
Dropped, picked up, pressure. And the pass is caught. The pass is caught right at the 20 by Ledbetter, a good tight end. He took a shot from Reed, and that may be what the penalty is about. Reed might have gotten there just a little bit too quickly.
Hiller made chicken salad out of that play, and
yes.
A nice diving catch by Ledbetter, the tight end.
Pass interference on the defense. Number 47, ball will be placed at the spot of the foul. First down.
It'll be a first down because of the penalty, and that's the good news for the Broncos.
Well, Ledbetter is a good red zone kind of guy, a short yardage guy, 6'5", 230, but he's more of a receiving tight end than a blocking tight end. He had 9 grabs for 101 yards against Miami last year, so he's a dangerous receiver. You have to respect him.
Lone setback is West. Ledbetter is a candidate for the Mackey Award and the Brandon Award. Looking, lofting toward the end zone, incomplete. Intended again for Jamarco Simmons. West Virginia had that one well covered. Antonio Lewis back there. Well, that's a surprise because he had a shoulder injury. We didn't think he was going to play.
But they try to get into a mismatch. We said that Jamarcus Simmons is a big kind of guy. Reminds you of a Marcus Colston from the New Orleans Saints. Going that fade pattern, he tries to just use his size, and good defensive effort calls for a second down. But Simmons, that was a good try anyway, with Simmons was a primary target there.
West and Thompson are split out of the shotgun. The inside handoff and down to about the 14-yard line is Glennis Thompson. He's out of West Palm Beach. Both these teams, as Williams made the tackle, have a lot of players from Southern Florida.
A lot of them. You know, we talked about Rich Rodriguez has 20 and Western Michigan has 22. You recruit there, most of them from Miami area. You know, and that's the hotbed of blue chip recruiting. So he brought him up here, and when you put that Florida kit out here in this turf, you got a lot of speed on the field.
You certainly do. Now they'll use a 5-receiver formation on 3rd down and 7. And there's the quick out. The pass is complete to Martin. Wide open because they were coming up to make the tackle on the first receiver. And now the left-footed kicking Mike Jones will put it up and miss. So that's costly for the special teams. There is a flag down, though. We'll await that ruling. Now, we had been told all week that Antonio Lewis had a shoulder injury and would not play. And here he is, so you never know.
Game time, John. You know, it's blood starts circulating a little bit. The juices start flowing.
Legal block. Legal block. 97. On the defense. Half the distance to the goal. We play the try.
Well, a costly penalty to the Mountaineers there after the miss of the
Correction.
Extra point.
96.
Well, that's the call, the illegal block called on Killeen Dykes. And give him another chance at it. So Mike Jones will get a second crack at it. Jim Laney the holder. Tom Harrington is the snapper. Trying to tie it up here. Late in the first quarter, and he just does. No, he did not.
West Virginia's defense thus far.
Maynard and Rivers, the deep man. And it's going to be a short kick taken at the 30-yard line by Rivers. A little room outside as he gets across the 40, goes out of bounds about the 42-yard line, a 16-yard return. We'll see if the Broncos can continue what has been a pretty good defensive show. Of course, they got a break in that fumble after that 59-yard pass play completion. Looked like the Mountaineers might be driving again, and that changed things around. But to their credit, then they took that ball and took it in for a touchdown.
Exactly right. They capitalize on opportunities, and that's what this game is going to be all about for Western Michigan. You have to capitalize on opportunities. Your special teams, which is a vital part of this game, have to be solid. And right now, West Virginia is starting in pretty good field position, you know, cutting the field almost in half.
At the 42-yard line. Slayton and White in the backfield. White with the quick out pass to Reynaud. Very close to a first down. Good running, but a flag comes in. Might be a hold there. Pritchard made the tackle, but we'll see what the officials say they saw. Reynaud with a good job and a nice spin move in there, but somebody was holding, I think.
bubble screen, which is a dangerous play. You know, they look at Pat White and Slayton and Reynaud. They think they have the most dangerous trio speed-wise in the country.
Well, certainly they have a wealth of talent.
Number 12 on the offense. 10-yard penalty. Replay first down.
So Nate Sowers was the guilty party, holding, trying to advance him out. He was very close to a first down, and now that's going to be wiped out as the ball will come all the way back. And Owen Schmidt will check in at fullback. Sowers also coming back in the lineup. Schmidt comes out now. Sowers is back in. 8 yards on the pass play, but wiped out by the penalty. And the Broncos are trying to change on the fly. That's tough to do.
Good camera work there. Got the penalty.
Well, he does get off. No, he did not. The flag goes off. Now, I don't know whether it's for that or for the delay of game. Burgess was trying to get off the field. And now the officials will huddle and talk it over.
Legal substitution on the defense. 5 yards from the previous spot. Remains first down.
And I think that's what that hurry-up offense sometimes can do to you.
Yeah, and you know, we talked about the jet. It could be either a regular tempo, which is, they call it a regular tempo, indie tempo, John, which is kind of in the middle, and the jet, which is, you know, full bore ahead. And
so you've got a regular car, you've got an indie car, and then you've got a jet.
that's about it. And they run the jet once in a while and catch you off guard, and that's what worked last time.
White with it. Gets away from one tackler, gets away from another. Fights his way forward, close to a first down. Austin Pritchard made the tackle for the Broncos. But White, showing his ability, picks up 8 on the play. Pritchard the tackle. Fake that inside handoff. You've got two guys with the kind of speed they have back there, it can drive you crazy.
And he sucked Marshall in a defensive end on that fake handoff to Slayton. It sucked everybody in, but also credit White with a pair of broken tackles. Great broken field running, picking up a first down.
Schmidt is back in there at fullback now. He'll be all over the place. Actually saw him quick kick in practice the other day. 7-6, Mountaineers lead. First quarter winding down. Slayton looking for room, won't get any. Dropped down that time by Burgess, made following the fumble. But that's one of the keys if you're an underdog like Western Michigan, as you said, if you can take advantage of those turnovers. Slayton with it, he's got some room up the middle. Cuts it out to the left side. They're chasing him down, he's at the 20, the 15, the 10, the end zone, touchdown West Virginia. 50 yards. And when Slayton got that room in the middle of the field, you could just kiss it goodbye right there.
Well, you know, there's a saying that Rich Rodriguez has, when you blitz, get the instruments ready. We're playing the fight song and kicking the extra point. And Western Michigan defense blitzed just now, and the Mountaineers made it pay for it.
He showed that terrific speed. Nobody was going to catch him from behind. So once again, it's Pat McAfee on for the extra point. And it is up and true. And the Mountaineers have had 3 possessions. They've scored on 2 of them. And after a 59-yard pass play, fumbled on the other possession. So far, their offense has really not been stopped.
And you know, the interesting thing is, we talk so much about Pat White with running ability. Both the scores have come via the pass. So a nice throw here. Great blocking downfield. That's a wipeout block. And good broken field running here. That's everything worked perfection. And again, West Virginia made him pay for that blitz package that the Broncos threw in. Good pass protection. And just throws it out there and lets him do the rest. And you can see
why. Oh, that was a pancake block right there.
Look at the offensive lineman downfield, though, John. That's just good running and good downfield blocking and sleep. You can see why he's so dangerous and a legitimate Heisman Trophy candidate. Good pickup. And you see a good feel from the end zone angle. And Slayton just runs away with that 4.36 speed, maybe. And Darren McFadden may have something to say about it. The fastest running back in the country.
That was Fichtner, by the way, that laid that block on that defender. And Slayton just took advantage of it. Motored 50 yards for his first touchdown. 34 in his career. You know, last year, the kind of job he did was unbelievable, even though he played basically with one arm. He did catch 2 touchdown passes last year. 16 rushing touchdowns a year ago.
And that's why he's so valuable, John, because, you know, not only is he a good runner, he blocks pretty well, Slayton does, and he's a good receiver in a slot. So, you know, when he gets to the next level, whenever that is, he's very much like a Marshall Faulk. You can do a number of things with him, and he's going to be a dangerous weapon on Sundays.
West will take it, drops it at the one, picks it up at the 20, slips down as he gets across the 20, and is put down there. Defensively, it was Andy Emery who made the tackle, a 19-yard return. And look at those career numbers for touchdowns.
And that's pretty impressive per carry, 6.3 yards and points per game. So he's automatic points when he gets his hands on the ball. He can do so much with him, either receiving or running with the ball. And again, he blocks pretty well, and he's a very durable guy.
Well, that's also, you talk about him with the good arms now. Last year played the entire season basically with one arm. He could only carry the ball in his left hand, which was his offhand.
Right.
So to me, that's got to make him even more difficult, because he can go either arm now that that wrist surgery was successful.
And he can use the arm to block, and he can switch hands and protect it. So
West is the lone back, fake the inside handoff. Hiller has some time. Now the pocket breaks down. He flips it to a receiver. Dykes was there. Brandon West was the receiver who caught the ball. Johnny Holmes as well in on that pressure. Well, he had a lot of time before the pocket collapsed.
But they had pressure. Western Michigan offense did a good job as much as possible. But look, they bring the blitz here, and they do as much as possible. But just after a while, a pocket collapses, and Hiller just has to do something with it. Just, woo, get rid of it. But you can see a nice play as West Virginia just kept them all bottled up and didn't let anything happen there. Good play by the Mountaineer defense.
Minute 45 remaining, opening quarter. Second and 13. And there's the little dump off to Ledbetter, the tight end. And he is tripped up and dropped on the play by Williams. Larry Williams, a senior from Highland Springs, Virginia, made the trip up tackle as he came up just short of the original line of scrimmage. But I think we've got a discussion, and it's going to be a clip against the Broncos. And sometimes when you get that guy that far out, you lose the angle trying to make the block.
Exactly. Guys are trying to get out there, trying to help out a little bit, and the angle is not good to block.
Clipping, number two on the offense. Half the distance to the goal, still remains second down.
So it's Brandon West who was called for the clip. It'll be second down, but the football will be pushed deep into Bronco territory. All the way back to the 10-yard line. That's where they'll have it, so it'll be second down and 20. 14-6, Mountaineers have scored on two of their three possessions here in the opening quarter. Clock is winding down, gorgeous day. Temperature in the upper 70s, plenty of sunshine. West again, the lone setback. Hiller works out of the shotgun on second and long. Fake the inside handoff. Hiller looks, throws short. West makes the catch. Gets outside the 10 to about the 12-yard line before he's nailed. Johnny Dingle, number 92, a senior. Another one from Miami, Florida, there for the defense. Gain of three, and there you see the clear skies, a sold-out crowd of 60,000, and down at that far end zone. Be making a lot of changes here in the hills of West Virginia. They've added some suites down at that north end, and after the season is over, they're going to take out the other end and redo all of the locker rooms, the weight room. It's all going to be redone. All part of the package for Rich Rodriguez, and that's part of the reason he's still here.
He deserves it.
Still third and long. Hiller looking, throwing downfield. Caught. Terrific catch by Jamarco Simmons. There were defenders there. Williams was with him, went up for the ball, but Simmons makes the catch and picks up a big first down for Western Michigan.
Facing a zone, again, a penalty will bring it back.
Yes, sir. Wipes it out. Well, let's take a look at the replay. After we get the call from the official, we think we have spotted the infraction for Western Michigan. That's going to wipe out a nice game.
Holding. 67 on the offense. Half the distance to the goal.
That's Rob Johnson, rather.
It's third down.
There he is, number 67. Working on number 95, Ingram. It was a great catch. 26-yard pass play is wiped out. Now the ball's back at the 7-yard line again.
You see how Jamarco Simmons finds gaps in that zone defense, and you know, he's not the fastest, but very, very effective. 61 grabs, 688 yards last year.
Dennis Thompson is the running back. And that's West, who's wrapped up quickly. He got back to about the line of scrimmage, maybe another yard or two before Mark Magro, the senior from Morgantown, made the tackle, and that's going to end the first quarter of play. Mountaineers have the lead after the first 15 minutes, all on pass plays. The last one was a 50-yarder. Great job. There's the slant for the first touchdown. They got another one later. They lead it 14-6 as we head to the second quarter in Morgantown.